to another episode of Conversations with LaQuisha. I'm your host, LaQuisha Williams, and on today's show, we will be talking about flaws and all. Yes, with flaws and all, I'm able to do what I'm doing today. Yes, with flaws and all, I'm sitting behind the camera. Despite what I was thinking in my head, and despite what I felt other people would say about me. Yes, if you know me, and those who don't know me, you will get to know me. One of my biggest things that held me back was not so much a fear, but because of what I thought somebody else would have said about me. For instance, my accent. I was like, oh my God, people won't be able to understand you. But when I talk to my girlfriends, they're like, LaQuisha, why do you keep saying that? We understand you perfectly clear. And so that built my confidence. And then I had people walk into my life that said, you know what, you can do this. And what my mentor, Jaquita Lee, she told me, she said, LaQuisha, you can do this. You know, she was one of the first persons who came to me and said, that gave me a platform to speak on. And that platform had changed my life forever. She saw something in me that I didn't see in myself, to speaking and sharing my story with others. So with flaws and all, on this week's show, with flaws and all, you are to do anything. You can't do anything. Yes, I thought that my color, that I would be too dark. But then when I look at it, Oprah, they had a problem with Oprah being in front of the camera. And look who she is today. So do not allow anybody or anything to stop you from being your true self. You know what happens if we deny our flaws, if we run from our flaws, then we are running from our true being. Who are you? Who are you? You are made up of all your flaws and all your imperfections. John Legend said, have the song that says all of me. I want all of you. All of your imperfections. That's what makes you unique. That's what makes you stand out. Because no one out of the 7 billion people on this earth, no one is like you. Before caught me 10 years ago, I thought that I wasn't cute enough, and then in a relationship where my ex-boyfriend thought that I needed to upgrade a bit, that I was getting too big. And I'm like, geez, if I keep adjusting myself to what this one says, that one says, that one says, I'm going to eventually lose myself. Yes, and I did that. That happened to me. I lost myself because I wanted to be how he wanted me to be. I was a size 4. We were dating. I end up being a size 8, I think it was. That was too big for him. So I was trying to exercise, do all of this, and then guess what? He still left. What? After I thought about adjusting my flaws, trying to stay inside, thinking that I was not gonna get any darker, to adjust to what he wanted, I lost myself. So I've decided that no matter what comes, no matter what goes, that I am going to love who God has created me to be. And this week on Conversations with LaQuisha, I don't care who said it, your mom, your dad, your friend, your boyfriend, do not stop being you. Embrace all of you. Embrace your imperfections. Because you know what? We are not really humans if we don't have something that we are afraid of or that we are ashamed of. You can look at magazines and they spend tons of hours trying to recreate and try to make it look perfect. Why? Because all of us have flaws. As hard as it may seem, loving your flaws, it is possible. Because if you don't love your flaws, then you're not loving who you were created to be. Without loving your flaws, you are denying yourself. So I urge you, love those curves, love those rolls, love those freckles, love those pimples on your face. Why? Because when you love you, the world loves you. When you are confident in you, the world is pushing and cheering you on. If there's a flaw that you don't like, see if you can change it. Basically, see if you can change it. And all flaws are not physical, so it doesn't mean that you have to go and do cosmetic surgery or anything like that. All I'm saying is see if there's a flaw that you can change. If you want to talk better or articulate your words, go back to school, go to Toastmasters. Those are some of the things that you can change. You can self-talk in the mirror. Look in the mirror and keep talking to yourself until you get that confidence within so that it can flow without. Secondly, most of us criticize ourselves more than others. Because how many of you know, so most of the times we see things that others don't see. Think about that. You may see, oh my God, I'm getting so fat. I can't do this. And then the world is looking and saying, you're fine. You're perfect. You're nice. Like, what are you talking about? So zoom in. Look at it from the world's perspective and see what they're seeing about you. Sometimes there is absolutely nothing wrong with you, but it's your self-sabotage, and we begin to think these things and see ourselves a way outside of how God wants to see us. Lastly, you want to accept it for what it is. Accept that you were born black. Accept that you were born Hispanic. Accept that you were born white. Accept it. Because the thing is, you can't do anything about it. Now, accept it and show the world that you love being who you are so that you can change the generation, so that you can change the world. Be yourself. Just accept it. Accept who you are and be the best you can be. Until next time, this purpose journey, we need some more people who will do it with flaws and all. I urge you this week, it doesn't matter what it is that's holding you back. I challenge you, do something that's going to scare you. Do something that your flaws will thank you for later. Embrace your flaws. Do not run from them. Until next time, visit my website, Let's Connect, and unleash that inner confidence. And do it with flaws and all.
'Cause all of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges. All your perfect imperfections. Give your all to me. I give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning. Even when I lose, I'm winning.